He just went all in. He's all in. And the snap call, let's go! $20,000 pot! Oh my god, it was an all-in on the call! Another $20,000 pot!
Oh, what the?
Dickie Bush makes the call! $20,000 in the middle!
Sicky Bush with the pocket fives in the big blind. Gonna raise it up here.
A lot of poker lovers in the chat.
Oh, wow.
Oh, of course the birds here right next to Sticky Bush. He's going to put on the raise, make it 500 clean to go.
Wow, and
Sticky Bush not deterred. Wants to play hand. We're going to see one.
Blind versus blind action too. Two pocket pairs.
Oh, my God. Set right in the window. Bat. Sticky Bush flopping it.
Wow. Oh, my gosh. Welcome to TCH Live, Sticky Bush. And such a dry flop for aces, too.
He checks over to Hallie, who was the three better, and he is going to continue for 350. Sticky Bush staring at middle set. Definitely doesn't have to worry about too many straight draws going on here, so he can put on the heat, put him on exactly the kind of hand he has.
1,000 more. Wow. You know, and Sticky Bush can very much well do this with hands like pocket nines, tens, eights even, trying to get some protection against overcards from like ace, king, and king, queen.
And Hallie with the toppest of pair is going to make the call. We're going to see a 10 on the turn. Sticky Bush still at set. And the betting lead, we'll go ahead and bet $2,500. Already a huge hand.
Unfortunate spot for Hallie, but I don't think he can fold just yet. And wow, going to the river, there's already 8,700 in the middle, and Hallie only has 5,400 back.
A king on the river will solidify the check mark from Mr. Sticky Bush.
Wow, and a check from Sticky Bush.
Unreal. The discipline. Trying to get just kind of sneaky.
I mean, with this run out, you'd have to think your aces are good here to go for some more value. It'd be a very impressive check back from Hallie.
No way. He just went all in. He's all in. And the snap call, let's go! $20,000 pot right away!
Wow. Oh, unfortunate hand there for Hallie. I mean, I don't think there was anything he could do there.
Three rolling, right?
Yeah, he's 10K free rolling right now.
Hallie, though.
Yeah, he's going to attack that weakness.
He's going to raise it up to $200 to go. See if anyone's got anything to fight with. Back to Jay Diggles with 9-8 off. Making the call. See you, Bush.
All right, let's see some redemption here for Hallie. Maybe some clubs on the flop.
I see a king and two clubs.
Oh, wow.
And two pair for JD. Oh, my gosh. Oh, man. Hallie,
wow.
On face value, it looks like he's got this board locked up, but he's definitely got some contenders.
I mean, and we also have the two biggest stacks of the table in the pot, too. JD is definitely not going to be slow playing this hand. I mean, I imagine it's going to go bet, raise, three bet from JD, because it's kind of a tough spot here. I mean, you don't want to just call and invite Sticky Bush in. Yeah, and I like this play a lot from JD. I don't like slow play on my bottom two pairs, and he agrees. Gonna make it 2,300 to go. Sticky Bush now in a situation here.
This has been a wild first few hands.
Definitely woke me up.
Sticky Bush is gonna release the naked flush draw. Now Hallie with a pair and a king high flush draw.
Oh, man. I mean, he only has 7,400 back. This might just be an all-in from Hallie. You don't want to just call, hit your club, and then lose all your action from a hand like a set or two pair. He's going to play it safe in position.
Big hand already. 5,300 bucks in the middle.
This is a very big turn card here.
That's enough.
Oh, no.
Oh, my God. Pairs the board, JD, with nines full.
And Hallie cannot catch a break.
Drawing to one last king in the deck. As one is mucked.
Oh, wow, and a check. I guess he just really... very interesting blind here from JD. The check, 3-bet check.
Standard. And the check back from Hallie. Nice to see there. And see a river card, blank.
Man.
So might save Hallie a little bit of money.
You know, fortunate for Holly, he has two clubs in his hand, so it's very hard for JD to have many bluffs at this point that contain a club.
Oh, he rips it.
I mean, it's obviously it's queen 10 of clubs, jack 10 of clubs. Still very much a possibility. What's so gross about that turn card, it makes it much less likely that JD could have a hand like a set of nines. So the only real value hands he could have here are like eights full. This is all from Holly's perspective too, right? Like eights full and kings full. But you expect JD to be, you know, playing kings a lot more aggressive preflop. So, and Holly has a king in his hand. So the only real possible hand is eights full or nines full of eights. And you know, JD did have it this time, so good fold from Holly.
And with that, we're back to the action. See if anybody wakes up with anything to play with. It's going to be an open here from Rom. Ace 9 off in the hijack.
And we got some beard critics in the chat.
not really a game for me. I can't really critique. I don't have a good enough.
I can't say anything either. I don't have. When I do, it's pretty patchy.
So we'll leave the discourse to our chat.
Yeah.
It's going to be a call here from Sticky Bush, the 9-7 off. We're getting a little bit frisky now, sitting on a stack of some chips. And finds a 7 in the window, but Ace-Jack-7, top pair for Rom.
Appreciate all the love, guys. Appreciate it. Yeah, top pair holding here for Rom. Especially being in position, I'd be tempted to check occasionally. With, you know, kind of a weaker ace, you're in a very way ahead, way behind situation. Oh, but I guess this bet here is going to induce a raise here from Sticky Bush. And I guess it serves another purpose as well. When you check back a hand like top pair on the flop, you don't get put in situations like this if your opponent does decide to bluff, because it's very hard to continue multiple streets with just ace nine. Oh, wow. And the money card for both players. Unfortunately,
wow.
Sticky Bush is pipped in his two pair.
Two pair versus two pair here on the turn on what could be a draw heavy board.
And if you're gonna check raise 9-7 and turn two pair like this, it's hard to get away from it. Rom with 9K effective. We could see a over 10K pot here. Or sorry, excuse me, over 20K pot again. Kind of an interesting spot here. I mean, you know, hands like sets are a real possibility, but you know, with the flush draws out there, a lot of other combo holdings here.
Was it all in a call? Oh my god, was it all in a call? Another $20,000 pot with two pair versus two pair. Drawing a 1-7 in the deck is Sticky Bush. Can he find it? No.
Well, terrible river card for both players, but it's going to be two pair over two pair.
Aces and nines, the best hand. Rom doubles up through Sticky Bush.
20K pot. Wow, that's the second 20K pot of the night. Going to Rom.
3-bet pot here. Matt with a 10-7 getting frisky. Sticky Bush calling with a 450 with a 6-5. Ooh, 285 is the like goal. JD with kings. He makes it 15-50 to go. Matt, three betting with some rags. Sticky Bush, oh my god, makes the call with 6-5. A four-bet pot. 6-5 offsuit is in the mix. Oh, my God. Ace high. JD sitting on kings. If he checks it over. Oh, my God. He's not going to check. He's going to bet. If Sticky Bush wants to get really aggressive here, he could get it done. Oh, my God. He just makes the call, setting up a huge turn.
Back from getting some waters here. Wow, what's going on here?
Jack of hearts. Everything gets there. JD, though, sitting on the nut flush draw with this pair.
I mean, having the king of hearts in a four-bet pot, it's very hard for your opponent to have some kind of a reasonable hold in that would be that would contain two hearts. JD going to check it over to Sticky Bush now.
Oh, the stare into his soul. He's going to pick a number. That's like 1750.
Very value heavy there. I mean, begging for a call, really making it look like he has the flush.
Doug R says flush, seat though. Open. Jeez. JD is going to make the call. He is the one with the check mark.
I mean, he's setting up a river jam here.
Four of diamonds. Just second pair for JD. He checks it over to Sticky Bush, and Sticky Bush cannot win this hand by checking.
I mean, the only bet that could ever actually work is an all-in. Oh, no. Come on. Oh, man. 3,000.
So valuey.
I think JD's too smart for this.
I can see it. What is he going to do?
If I were JD, I might try to engage Sticky Bush with some table talk here and be like, why didn't you just go all in?
He doesn't believe him.
Yeah, I think if Sticky Bush was deeper, we might see JD turn his kings into a bluff using that King of Hearts blocker. But, you know, there's just not enough money behind for him to get to fold that.
He makes the call!
Really great
call. Sick
call.
Shows the 6-5, and the kings are good.
I just, when you're facing an opponent like Sticky Bush, and I'm sure he's started to notice and take note that. Pretty aggressive player.
15,000 in there going to JD. So very nice of you. And Gmon with a sub. Thank you. Guys, lots of chats after that hand. I want to be JD when I grow up. Yeah, me too.
RV Phil B. I wonder if that's Phil from the Wednesday game. It is? Hey, what's up, RV Phil? So I'm playing with you the other day. Hope you're doing all right.
Alice Acuna in the chat.
I had the pleasure of playing with RV Phil on Sunday. Played some 2-5 with him. He mentioned to me that he... Oh, whoa, what's going on here?
An all-in from Sticky Bushy's... I don't want to say tilted, but he's all-in with the Jack 10. He's going to get a call from Zane. He's not... He's got two left cards. That's for sure.
I mean, 60-40, not the worst.
Jack on the window, or not the window, Jack on the flop, excuse me. 8 on the turn. Jack's good currently, and it continues
and
to be good.
One time there. Nice hand there for Sticky Bush. Going back up to his starting stack there.
So basically Zane paying for the big hand previous. When he did play on our Tuesday game.
Sticky Bush in there again.
I love it. I love this guy.
Let's see how these players adjust to all the limping going on from Sticky Bush. I mean, I don't imagine Z, which is going to fold. Like, if he's going to put in 50 bucks, he can't fold when it's heads up like this.
And you can see now JD bringing up the price. There, I think that's the adjustment you're talking about. The open isn't $200 anymore.
Yeah, he raises $325.
Ace on the board here, the flop. JD's got the best of it. Second pair for Sticky Bush, drawing to a queen or tray.
Yeah, Sticky Bush definitely going to lose some value here. Or, sorry. Definitely going to lose some money here. I mean, can't fold just yet, floppy second pair. Just against a very strong and capable opponent like JD.
Six on the turn, no improvement. $600 to go.
No fear from Sticky Bush. Looking for that queen or three now.
Does not find it. Only second pair, no kicker for Sticky Bush. JD trying to outplay his opponent here. Can he get any more value? Going to go with $600, the same bet.
Really targeting a queen, like king, queen, or queen, 10. Oh, wow, and a raise.
And he makes the quick call. JD makes an extra $1,000 on top.
3,000 in profit there for JD. Okay, Sticky Bush with a real hand now. And a three bet with sixes.
Oh, man, and Zane's got kings.
Oh, boy.
All right, it's go time. Hold on to your butts.
I mean,
$1,100. That's the price. Pay it.
With Sticky Bush covering Zane, I could see Sticky Bush just shoving here, putting him on like a hand like ace king or king queen suited.
And now it's back to Sticky Bush, who's going to make the call, and we're going to go and see a flop. Will Sticky Bush find a set? He will not. But it's an ace high board, though. And he's going to donk.
The classic donk from Sticky Bush.
Oh, my God. 475 against kings on an ace high paired board. Zane, though, makes the call. Good call so far. A six or a six only. There's only one left in the deck. He doesn't find it on the turn. 10 of hearts. Oh, he checked, gives up to Zane. And he checks back. River card coming.
Zane definitely has more.
He's going to go for some thin value. And he folds the sixes. Nice fold.
No, he called.
Wait, what? Oh.
He snap called.
Oh, he didn't. Okay, he didn't put a chip in. He just tabled his hand for Sticky Bush. Zane, fortunately for him, makes
getting
you extra
max, yeah, getting the max value there from Zane. I mean, if he limped with the queen three of clubs, I imagine he'll do the same with the diamond variety.
Oh, and jacks for Hallie. Gonna open it up, make it $200.
Oh, I think he could have gone a lot bigger there.
Oh, and king's back to back for Zane. He's gonna sneak it. He's gonna make the call. Jim V Queen Six probably not playing his hand.
Oh wow, Zane is playing the stack.
JD.
Holly here, hoping for a clean flop. I mean, if it comes like six or seven high on the flop, we could see Zane and Holly can play a
mass
one.
Wow, a lot of playables here. 10-9 for Beck's gonna make the call. Sevens for Matt getting a million.
Oh my gosh!
Oh my God, Sticky Bush.
The limp re-raise and like
$1,550. Hallie sitting on pocket jacks with four players left to act.
And Zane is so under-repped right now. Hallie has to think he's good here. He might just jam and try to isolate Sticky Bush, he's just gonna run into the hand of Zane.
Oh no!
He sends it all in for $7,700. Zane sitting on kings.
Yeah. And
oh my goodness.
And this wouldn't have happened if Sticky Bush hadn't done the limp three bet. And now
Zane
Holly
rips
knows.
It.
Now Holly knows he's no good because. Oh no. Oh, what the?
Sticky Bush makes the call. Let's go. 20,000 in the middle.
Wow, is that 20,000 even?
Yeah.
Wow, and Holly's just like, really? Zane, you're going to slow play the kings and get.
Mark getting the pot right. It's a huge pot.
Oh.
Six, deuce, deuce. All but close to drawing dead for Sticky.
And Holly.
Holly drawing to jacks, and that's pretty much it. I don't think he has the jack of spades in his hand, does he? He does have the jack of spades. Okay.
Zane has
the king of spades. Okay, fair enough. All right, well. Drawing very slim. Eight is not it. Now Sticky drawing dead. Four is a clean run out. Kings gets the whole thing.
Wow, $20,000 pot for Zane. And Holly, after being felted twice, I don't know if he's going to continue. He's had a really rough night.